So today, day 27, we're talking about audience. We're going to talk about how to grow your audience on social media, how to keep your audience, and how to have a loyal audience of people that are engaged. There's nothing worse than a page that you might see or a YouTube channel or whatever with a ton of followers or a ton of subscribers and zero engagement. It's the weirdest thing. It's almost like a ghost town, right? The way that you avoid this is that you create an engaged audience, that you have that care factor, that you do want to talk to them, that you ask questions, that you engage back and forth with them, and it's not just you talking at them. So the greatest tip that I can give you, and in the past year, my social media has grown tremendously. I haven't really done anything astronomical, but I can share with you the things that I know that move the needle. It had nothing to do with the things I posted. I didn't have a viral post or an amazing photo that, you know, some Ellen DeGeneres shared or anything like that. It was literally just through being consistent. I didn't even post every day. I always shared on my stories, though. I always showed up on stories no matter what, even if I didn't feel like it. But if there was a comment left under a photo, I engaged, I replied, usually within the hour of that photo going up. But more than that, in my DMs, if someone replied to a story with a heart, I took the time to engage with that person. There is nothing worse than a thumbs up. I feel like everybody needs to have that on like a poster board and understand how not cool the thumbs up emoji is. It's just the ultimate, like, I don't really have time to reply to you right now. So, and that's kind of how I see it. So I never want to do that with a heart emoji or a thank you. I always try and take the time to engage with my audience, to reply to questions, even if it's just them sending some love, because I try and put myself in their shoes as to when I was me before I had a social media following, before I even got on Instagram or on YouTube, and I was someone that might have just left a heart or a, by the way, just a really, you know, not too much, because, you know, deep down in my core, I am a shy person and I'm not that much of a social being. And I know that my audience could and very well be the same. So I take the time to give the love, to reply back, because that person took time out of their day to look at my stuff. And may I just say that, especially in the beginning when my stuff wasn't that great, not that I think my stuff is that great now, but my stuff was really not that great in the beginning. So if someone actually took the time to say, Angie, thank you, or I worked out today because of you, that meant the world to me. But one shift that I have made over the last 12 months, hands down, that has completely altered not only the growth in views on my stories, the growth in views on my videos, I respond to everything as best I can. Obviously, some fall through the cracks, so don't at me if you sent me something and I missed it, but we always do our best. I do my best to reply to every single comment, every single DM with as much heart and help as I possibly can. Now, for the business owners listening to this, if it doesn't lead to a sale, you should still answer it. Don't be that person that you're like, well, just because it's not gonna lead to a sale, I'm not gonna engage in this. The best line I ever heard was, yeah, you know, Jimmy John might be messaging you wanting to know about sneakers, but his aunt could be like the next Fortune 500 person that wants to invest in your company. Like, you don't know. Just be a good freaking person and answer people. And the best example I can give you of this is when I first started my business, this girl called Bianca, she wanted to sign up in my group, in my fit gym. And she asked me if she needed the resistance bands. She already had the program. So I thought, well, yeah, you can join. It's cool. So she came in, didn't buy anything from me. And she said, but I need the resistance bands. And I could have sold her the resistance bands. On their own, I obviously offer that. But I said, dude, you can either order them for me. They'll probably be more expensive. You're gonna have to pay for shipping. Why don't you just go to your local Walmart? I literally just went and they had like a pack of three in a little bag that you can get. And it's like $5. I would just rather you do that. And she said, really? And it's okay? And I said, yes. That girl went on to not only do multiple programs with me and continue on in the fit gym, she ended up being a coach on my team and ended up signing up with another program. Like, so much more happened down the road. And I'm forever grateful for that. But it really was just the decision to be a freaking good human and not be all about the sale and just help that person. Another example, questions that I get all the time is, where did you get that piece of clothing? Where did you get that pair of running shoes? If it doesn't lead to a sale, that's okay. Just engaging with humans. If people want to know, you know, other coaches that want to know, there could be coaches that aren't my coaches that are watching the Daily Grind right now. That's okay. I am in it to help people. There can be, it can end there. That's my point. It can end there, that you just want to help someone. There doesn't have to be anything in it for you. It could sometimes feel better to know that a life was changed because of you. And trust me, your stuff will grow from there just by being a good freaking person. And that's how you grow, I think, an engaged audience. The other thing, questions. You can ask questions on your stories and actually care. Like, I love getting opinions of all sorts of stuff, whether it is to go with this plant or this plant on my front porch, or what do you guys think of this, or when should I do this, or what do you want to see next. The best cues that you can ever take on how, which way to navigate your social media and how to grow it, will always be from your audience. It's the questions that they're asking you. So if you're not in your DMs and you're not in your comments responding and having conversations with the people that care about you the most on the interwebs right now, then how do you know which direction to go in? They're going to tell you. I never knew that the direction of my channel and the thing that I would end up talking about most was freaking cuppies and tiered trays and home tours and morning routines. I never thought that that would be, but because I listened to my audience and I knew what they wanted to see, it took me in a direction that I never thought that I would go in, but I freaking love it. And it ended up growing because it's what people wanted to see. And I paid attention and I talked with them. So be in your DMs like a crazy person, reply with more than just a thumbs up. Be a human, be about helping people first, and let it end there if it needs to. And it could come back, it could not. It's all good. You'll be better for it. And your audience will grow. You got to be patient, you got to be consistent, you got to stick with it, but your audience will grow. So I hope that this helped. I hope that this hit home. If you agree, if you don't agree, let me know down below. Let me know that you're still here, because we are on our home frickin' stretch. I will see you tomorrow. Bye, dude.